Hey guys, it's Nikki with This Robin's Nest. So in today's video, I'm gonna share a yard sale haul, but I'm also gonna give you my biggest tip for yard sales, because you guys are always asking me like, how do you find such great things? And it's like, you get exactly what you're looking for. And there's a secret to it. So I'm gonna share it with you guys today. It's one of my favorite websites. It's called yardsales.net. And I'm gonna take you into the room where the lighting's probably not gonna be that great, but I'm gonna show you on the computer because it's an amazing resource and it's time that I shared it with you guys.
First, yardsales.net. This is the site that I use, I was telling you guys about, and it's so easy to use and it's awesome. It's completely free, they don't charge. It's a really great resource if you like to go to yard sales. So I've listed on their site in the past when I've had yard sales. They're called the Girly Girl Yard Sale, and they've been really, really successful. And then I also use them as a daily search. So what you can do is enter in your location and it will show you all the yard sales that are close to where you are in your local area. So these are the ones that pop up for me today. Now, what else you can do is you can sign up, create an account, and they will send you emails. You can enter keywords of what you're looking for. So if you're looking for milk glass like I do, and you guys always wonder how I find it, or any of the other items when you go, oh my gosh, you find so many great things. Guess what? I enter in keywords like furniture, milk glass, library card catalog, all those things, and I will show you in my email. They send me emails with the yard sales that are local to me that include items that I'm looking for. So this is what a daily email would look like from my email, and this actually is one that I just received. And as you can see, if you can see my little mouse moving around down here on the screen, these highlighted areas where it's like a highlighter yellow, those are the keywords that I entered. So it's telling me a keyword I entered is furniture, that there's furniture available for sale at this yard sale, which is local to where I live in Puyallup. And you can see that all the way down. There's two sales that have keywords and one that's local that does not have any of the keywords that I'm looking for. So today it's Wednesday, and as of today, I have 6 sales that are happening locally. I normally only go on Fridays and Saturdays. So unless I see something that's like a screaming deal or I don't want to miss, I usually don't check until this evening, and then I start to map for the coming weekend. And I can see other surrounding cities too, so I know if I want to go a little bit further out. You can see there's my route tab right here. So when I log in, once you've created an account, which I highly recommend that you do, and you save all the yard sales that you want to go to, you can create your own route and you will have it and be ready to go.
Okay, so now that I've shared my secret with you guys, I really hope that you use it, because I think it'll make a difference in the items that you're finding at yard sales. Because if you just drive around kind of aimlessly and looking for signs on the side of the road, it can take up a lot of time, and people like me are getting there first thing because I already know about the sale ahead of time and I've already planned my route and I'm already there before you even know it's happening. So you guys, check it out, and if I see you at one of my local yard sales, we'll just have to negotiate over who gets the really good stuff. All right, so let's get into this haul, and I'm gonna show you guys what I picked up over the weekend. The first sale that I went to was at a kind of an adoption ministry, and they were closing down and they rent a house, I guess, and they were just clearing out a bunch of things that they had collected over time. And I found these amazing wooden pieces for 10 cents a piece, and they were made in another country that I can't pronounce, but I'll show you on the back of one and I'll try to explain it. But for 10 cents, they were handmade by women. They picked them up on a mission trip there, and I thought, these are so popular right now. I've seen them at Pottery Barn, just this wood, natural wood. And this is like a catch-all tray. You could put candles on this. You could just throw your keys on it on an entryway table, and for a dime. I was very excited to get this. On two more pieces, this is probably the one that I favored the most, and it can hold a number of different things. You could use it for jewelry, or you know, a number of different kind of storages in an office on your desk, and put some washi tape in it. And it's just really, really gorgeous in that natural wood. And finally, I found this piece here. They were all on top of a fireplace mantle, and this one's really unique and cool, and I think it's for a taper candle on the top. I'm not really sure, but it's a great decorative piece that will get used in my new home. And on the side it says, from Tezera Cabedo. I'm not really sure, I'm probably butchering that name terribly, but anything that's handmade by someone should just be, you know, taken care of really well and really appreciated. So I paid 30 cents for all three of those pieces. It cost me $3, and this is great for a candy dish, or you can use this in an office again and just separate like your paper clips or different things like that. And it's got that awesome hobnail detail. Look at that, you guys. I mean, oh my gosh, I just melt when I see this stuff. It's just, I don't know if it's the texture or what it is, but I just love that hobnail detail. And this is stamped on the bottom. And this is marked Fenton on the bottom there. It's so bright outside that I can't see in the viewfinder what you guys can see. So hopefully that shows up. This is the other piece that I was able to find. And this is stamped with a W on the bottom. I'm not really familiar with that. I'll have to look it up. But you guys can see the detailing there. It's kind of got like this pyramid pointy kind of design to it. And with some little medallions or something. I don't know. But the lid looks like that. And again, another great candy or storage dish. I could use this for cotton balls or something in the bathroom. I don't know. It's just another one to add to my collection that I haven't seen before and is a little bit more unique. I was able to find one piece of Pyrex. This cost me a quarter. It's just a little dish. I don't have any other matching pieces, but I thought it was a cute little seasonal piece for a catch-all. This was my most expensive splurge over the weekend. I found this trio of, I guess you call them appetizer sets. These are 24 karat gold plated mini spoons. They're so adorable. And the packaging looks kind of dated, so I think they're older. And then it came with this. It says 24 karat gold plated. So let me show you what one looks like. Oh my gosh, you guys, these are like the cutest things ever. And they're so shiny. And I'm excited to use them, especially in fall entertaining. And they were $5 a box, so I paid $15 for all of them. I will show you the other two. Okay, and then we have the forks and, like, I guess the cheese spreaders or the knives. And they're so tiny, and I think they're just so adorable. And they kind of remind me of, like, Anthropology. I like that little bit more of eclectic mix and match serveware. So I picked those up. So this is a completely random purchase and find, but we actually went into the Goodwill, which I know is a thrift store. It's not necessarily a yard sale, but it's still thrifting. And this cost me about $1.49, and it's a bowling pin, like an actual really heavy bowling pin. And it says ABC approved. And so I don't know if that's like the official bowling pin something, I don't know, but it's registered 3429 with a permit number. So I don't know, I just thought it was really cool. It's not something that you come across every day, and how fun would this be in like a guy's den or game room or movie room, something like that. So I picked this up in hopes that my husband could use it for decor somewhere, because we really want to find him a space. I've had an office and he doesn't really use an office, but I still want to do something for him. So I picked this up to use for later on. One of the sales that I went to over the weekend, this lady, I mean, she did an incredible amount of crafting because she just had bins and bins and bins of crafting stuff. And she was asking 50 cents for this ribbon. I offered her a quarter, and it's from Michaels, but it's got such an old school label. Hey, Bella Boo, you want to say hi?
Hi.
Hi. And it's got the sweetest little retro owl print on it for Halloween. And so for a quarter, I thought, even if it's just for inspiration, I really like this, I'm gonna pick it up. I also snatched these guys for a dime a piece. There's a little sitting deer, and then there's one that's standing. And I think they're just really, really, really sweet. And I found this book, it cost me 50 cents, and it's really old and it's really beat up, but it's really unusual, you guys. I've never seen one like this before. I'm gonna show you how it works here. And it's kind of funny, so you put your fingers through when you're reading the book, and I mean, I don't know, it just makes me laugh. Even if I got it for pure humor, I mean, come on. And we can go fishing on the dock. I don't know, this is a beak. There's also a dancing senorita and a kitty cat. This one cracks me up because it's supposed to be a nose, but I don't know. And it's a kid's book, but I don't know how I feel about this one. This is a little different, I don't know, but it's cute. So this was a fun and interesting find. All these books were from the same cell. This is The Restless Robin, and it has some really pretty graphics on the inside, quite a few to choose from. And these were all a quarter. Then there's the Look and Learn book. And again, I picked this one up to possibly use illustrations on the inside. And then there was this book just around the corner. This one didn't appeal to me, but my daughter liked it, so I picked it up for her. One of the sales that I went to, the lady that was there was an educator in the past, and she was getting rid of a bunch of her classroom materials, and it was a quarter for this whole, what do you call this, file folder, full of circus-themed graphics and, I guess, paper dolls, so to speak. So there's an elephant, tigers, creepy clowns, trapeze artist. There's the seal and horses and even a big top that you could put together. And so I thought that was fun, and I picked it up. Even if I'm doing like an inspiration board in my daughter's room, if she has a pin board, and you know, I could pin something like this up there to theme it. I don't know that she'd necessarily play circus with these. She might. But I will probably use it more on like an inspiration board. Thought that was fun. And at the same sale, she had three more folders, so I also picked up Animals and the Zoo. And then she had a colonial one that had like boxes that you would put together to create a village. And finally, there was a farm inspired one. So I picked up all four sets of those for a dollar. A few more children's books. These were 50 cents, and this is a Sleeping Beauty pop-up book. And I love this one. It's older, so I'm gonna have to be really careful with it, because I think it will tear easily. It's not one that I would let my daughter do by herself, but that I can read to her. Then at that same cell, there's this really nice journal. It's got the polka dot detail on the inside and just the regular lined pages. And it's this really pretty, you can see gray with like this gold metallic. And finally, for 50 cents as well, I also got this book, and it's not really one that I picked up to read, although I've heard good things about it. I picked it up just because it's got a robin's nest on the front, and I thought it would be great in decor. The final sale I went to, I got this Steve Madden handbag, and this cost me $2, so I was pretty excited about it because it's a great crossbody and color for fall. And let me just show you guys close up. It's that really pretty wine color, and there's some zipper detail on the front. It's nice and big. It's got some texture to it. And then on the back, it's got the texture with the little label, but you can hold this, you know, over the arm or crossbody. And for $2 for a seasonal fall bag, I was pretty pumped. It's pretty cool too. It's got like a chevron effect. I don't know if you guys can see that out here in the daylight. And then on the inside, I grabbed this wallet for $1. She had this there too. And I do like to carry nicer wallets, but you know, I think this is probably, I don't know, it might be a Target wallet or something like that, but it's in really good shape. So yeah, I think that's upside down. There we go. And it's a nice neutral. It's kind of like this tan color with a navy lining or like a charcoal lining. And for $3, a brand new bag and wallet for the fall, I'm all over it. Okay guys, so those are my yard sale finds, thrift finds from the weekend and most recently. And I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and check out yardsales.net. It's an awesome resource, and I'm excited to learn about your guys' finds once you do and if it helps you out. So I will see you in the next video. Have a great day. Bye.